Alright, mic check. Alright, let's see whether we can get this to work. Hello. Good to see you all here. Yeah, well, welcome everybody. Now, I know that this is a game here. I mean, Satisfactory is here and stuff like that. But, you know, I just felt like it was just something to going on in the background. I won't be playing this majorly seriously, probably. But it's not mainly just kind of just hang out. Just, I thought I'd do something different, have it on, like, the second channel and whatnot. Just see how things are going. Yeah, that and we're kind of building up the coffers for the honeymoon fund, pretty much. Just kind of like, because just some way that we can like have GIMP. So you can go to streamlabs.com/MasterCoX_TFS. Oh no. Wait, that didn't work. Yeah, no, that should do it. But basically, if you want to leave something there, you can leave a message, and it will be then contributed onto a wall of donators and pledges that will be shown at the wedding, or anything on Super Chat will be greatly appreciated. Michael Rent, your prom night's about to be there. Oh, that's cool. Glad that you can have a good time there. I hope you do. This is just more of a relaxed stream, really. I'm not, like, gonna be pinning a lot of... Let's just say I'm not gonna get hung up over, like, numbers and stuff. It's just, like, this is the thing. And I'm just glad that you guys could end up, like, just coming over and just chilling out. Very much appreciated. Don't mind the movement of a microphone. Just gonna get that into good position. Alright, cool. Going. Alright. Yeah, no, absolutely. Best luck to you, dude. Have a good time at your prom. Now, won't it be best to have a chat over there? Now, if I remember correctly, the last time I played this game, it was essentially like, it was a long time ago, really. I suppose, really, this could just be mainly background stuff. But yeah, anything super chat donations, very much kindly appreciated. In my regards, just get that bump out of the way. Oliver Spencer says, what if Trunks met Kid Bulma episode was really good? Well, thank you very much, man. I kind of like felt like I had to curtail it in a way that just made it not too, not to kind of over-egg the pudding, as it were. Aaron, what time is it in Britain? It is currently 9:36. And Tanya, if I was the official voice of Goku, that would just be silly. That's just a silly goose thing to say. NJG, this is a game called Satisfactory. It's like Factorio meets Minecraft in a way. You have to craft like factories and stuff. But currently at the moment, that's not really going about because something has been disconnected. I'm not sure what. So I'm on the mission to try and find out what's going on. You're absolutely correct there, Jason. That be me. Yeah, I think you know what? I'm probably just gonna change maybe. I'm not really feeling this game right now. I'm already feeling it. Let's see if we can actually change Super debrief stage. Nope, that's not what I want. Nope. Don't mind me, just going through all the different ones. Because I think there's YouTube 2018. No, that's not it. Nope. Nope. I think what we'll do is just, I'll move the webcam over to this second one over here. Turn the game off. The game, I'm not feeling the game, to be honest. So we'll just stick this over here. Yeah. Yeah. So apologies if people were curious about the game. I don't know. I was just not really kind of feeling it. I felt really, I kind of want more spend time talking to you guys, to be honest. So do excuse the lack of professionalism on my part. Don't mind me there. Oh yeah, the curtain. I'm actually, July, I'm actually definitely looking into, Instinct Knight, cool, thank you very much for the donation, thank you so much. I think, let's see if we can get that up, and, we can read messages here. Let's get this going. Check the info and settings. Hopefully it's not just stuck on gaming. Oh, it's people on blogs, okay. That's good. That is cool. That's all I wanted to know. That was pretty much good. So.
Hope you have a great wedding.
Oh, that was a message. Oh, cool. On £5. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I think that's Dandy Man. I'm basically just gonna go and check the list. As it were. I'll have a look for some background music. Yeah. Let's do that. Now, what's a good playlist? Dinner jazz. Oh, yeah. Ah. Okay. My mic muted? Is everything okay? Can you guys hear me? Okay, you guys can hear me. Cool. Right. It was probably just like that. I just thought I'd put on some things. So, I don't know if any of you remember, but this is like back in the days. Back in the days of the jazz stream. I used to do this like ages ago. Back on the days of blog TV. Does anyone remember blog TV? Like, it was just like, I don't know. It was very simple. I did a thing called the jazz stream. And I literally was just playing dinner jazz in the background. And that's pretty much what I did. And I'm not sure whether it will actually be feasible for me to do. But, you know, might just have to tone it down a teensy little bit. Just make sure that the content ID. Yeah, it doesn't go off too much. But yeah. No, blog TV was like ages ago. This was like circa 2010. I don't know. It was like a long time ago. And Orion, thank you so much. Watching the work since you were 8 years old watching Naruto Bridge. Wow. What, you were like 8 years old? You really shouldn't have been watching it back then. You really shouldn't have been watching it, but you know, it's all the same. Yeah, really, really appreciate it. And thank you so much. Yeah, it's been a long day. Been a long day. And Jay Andrews, thank you so much. Thank you for that. So I suppose we could like do it the old school thing. So Super Chat, if you have a question, if it's like you're really like a long list of people or something like that. Kit Cloud Kicker. You're getting married. I'm so happy for you. You deserve a lifetime of happiness for all that you've given us. Oh, thank you so much, Kit. Really do appreciate it. It was a long time coming, to be honest, and like, I think like I said in my shed talk that I did the other day, I was pretty content with just the idea that I would end up dying alone. I was like really prepared to be like that. It was just like the old thing, guess I'll die then. But I'm glad that I don't have that anymore, you know. There's always someone for you out there, someone who'll put up with you. Philly definitely puts up with me. But if I'm not here to tell you how to live your life. This is just how my one's played out. So, you know, it's all good. It's all good. Just relaxed. Really glad that people could at least just be here to chill. Oh. Tala the Boar. Okay, proposal advice. I try and think, the way I did it with Philly is that it had to be something. Now let's be real. Don't feel too much pressure that you feel like you have to do it in absolute style. Like, you absolutely have to make it really flashbang for it to be memorable or anything like that. Because at the moment, at that precise moment, the only two people that matter at that precise second are you and who you're proposing to. So, just have it somewhere where you think it's special. Somewhere it can be, that really kind of sums up your relationship. That's the best bit of advice I could give you. As in, this is just something that's between you two. Or three. Or however you want it to be. It just has to speak out and it's something that, you know, will really, really stick with you. I mean, with myself, it was a case of bad meat evil. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. It was a case, well, we were going on holiday around the cruise. And we were going to a place where there were loads of Game of Thrones tours, like going around all the places in, like, you know, Croatia, Slovenia, all the different places where they shot Game of Thrones stuff. And it was really, it just, the opportunity came in Dubrovnik, where they filmed King's Landing. And I thought, well, you know, that's just something that's really kind of fascinating, and I really enjoy that. And I thought, okay, perfect. I'll pick a moment where it's just the two of us and just do it. Yeah. I had the ring ready to go, had that all made, done in advance, and it was all just set up, and everything was just good to go. Yeah, Orion, yeah, it definitely got a boost because of GOT. But Croatia in itself is really nice. You know, it was just really, really good times. It was just a shame it was really, really hot back that summer. It was just like, oh my god, jeez. Just like, nearly up in the hundreds and extremely humid. Something that we were not used to. Well, yeah, Tarlo, to be honest, if it's something that you two will absolutely love and you'll cherish for the rest of your relationship or your lives, then do it. Because it's got to be something that you can easily tell your friends and say, you won't believe how they proposed. It was so memorable. It was so cute, or it's so lovely. You know, I let's just say I did it right. I did it right. And the ring, I designed it along with the ringmaker. And yeah, let's just say that it's constantly being gushed over. So I'm like, I'm happy about that. But you know, it was just something really good fun. Definitely good fun. But yeah. Hope everyone's doing all right. So, Orion, Israel in July with the heat. Yeah, I can only imagine, dude. You know, I have total empathy for anybody that lives in a hot climate. Jay Andrews, who'd win in a fight, Superman versus Goku? The audience, quite frankly. The audience definitely would. NJG, Endgame? Ooh. Okay. Right. Endgame thoughts. Oh, by the way, John Riggins. Hey, John. That's the guy who does the Dragon Ball Time Slip comic. The thing that's been What If Trunks Met Kid Bulma. Good chap. Very talented individual. Very good bloke. But, okay. Can't divulge it any longer. I would say Endgame. If I had to give it, like, either a sound or a motion, a sound would be like, yeah, sound is fine. Good ending. It stuck the landing. That's all I'll say, pretty much. Don't worry, John. I'm not going to spoil it. Let's just say it stuck the landing. If you were worried that it was going to just not be worth your while or worth your time or anything like that, you know, it was just, it's definitely worth your time. Oh, July, that's really cute. It's been a long journey. It's been a long journey. And Michael Rett, you're right. The audience wins. Definitely. Yeah, but anyone who remembers Bad Fanfiction Theatre, I do plan to bring something like akin to that back. But maybe with good fanfiction and dramatic reading. And I've actually bought a smoking jacket. Like a fancy one. Because the Gamington Smythe one was like really, that was something I found in a charity shop for like £8. This one was like, you know, I did spend a little more on it, but it's going to be for good fan fiction. We'll get a chair from a thrift store, something we can give it a new lease of life. And One Piece Hunter, thank you so much. Sorry I can't send more now. Don't worry about it. Anything is appreciated. Got a lot of debts to deal with. You should really focus on those, by the way. But just wanted to offer my congratulations, and I hope you two will remain very happy together. And a personal thank you for all the work you do for us. Well, you're absolutely welcome. Absolutely welcome, sir. Just, yeah, it's just a very interesting time. And we pretty much got everything planned, really. We've, got an extra special stuff that we've got planned. We're definitely going to make sure that our guests are entertained. One Punch Lanny versus Master UI Masako. Oh, no, that'd be interesting. I'm actually going to, anyone on the West Coast, I'm actually going to be going to AX. this year. No, definitely. So we're going to be going to LA for the first time and actually staying in LA and not something that, I used to do it. Hey, how you doing? Let's give you a mod ship while we're at it. There, yeah. So I'll be going to AX this year. So anyone in California, you'll you come over and say hi if you're going to AX. I'll get to see Lanny then. So at the very least, it'll be I'll either go and train with him, or I'll just go and do some skits or whatnot. But yeah, Huckstar, is it a big wedding or is it a small wedding? Actually, it's more of a... It's about 100 guests. So, 50 each side. Pretty much... It's pretty small. But, to be fair, the venue that we've got, the church, it's a very, if it was, like, gonna be like that, it's a pretty small church, but it's a very pretty one. It's a very pretty one, definitely. Any plans for going to a con in Manchester? Unfortunately not. I don't have any plans for that, I'm afraid. I have been to conventions in Manchester, but I'm going to one in Newcastle, actually, SunnyCon at the end of June. And I'll be going to London MCM. And I will have a booth there. So let's see. Spectre, thoughts on the new Sonic movie? I definitely have to say, I'd say it's a pretty solid movie, say, for that Sonic model. I don't know how that got past what they were trying to do there, whether they were trying to be realistic or something like that, but you can't be realistic with a blue hedgehog. Trust me. Philly and I, we've actually had some hedgehogs kind of, wandering around the house. We've either been rescuing them to make sure foxes don't get them. But definitely not something that we would have expected, Sonic like that. But... I think the idea of the director really kind of being receptive to audience feedback, that was a surprise. Definitely something I didn't expect. But yeah, it's definitely something interesting. No, Super Fighter, no, exactly. They are redesigning it. I think it was the mouth. The mouth didn't help. And it was just like the eyes. It just needed to be a bit more cartoony, Jaden, if Philly and I, we would definitely be Chi-Chi and Goku. That's pretty much it, really. It's definitely something that... It's something like along those lines. Damon, I am going to MCM London. I will have a booth. I'll be having a booth all weekend. So, want to come and say hi over that time? Feel free. Maybe pick up some merch or my signature for free or a picture for free. Either way, I'll be there. No, we're Goku and GT pretty much, Jaden. No, definitely. It's just that's pretty much what we'll be. But Jason, what if Bardock went super in his first fight with Frieza? Unfortunately, his power would be 500,000. So he'd be close to Frieza, but he would still not be strong enough. So, unfortunately, that's just how it's going to be. Unfortunately. Otaku Raditz. Jojo, I am currently in part 5, but I stopped at around episode 13 to give myself a bit of a pause, because just that means I can then go and watch a huge glut of episodes. Just to kind of make sure I had something to look forward to. Badlands, if I had a kid and I would train, would I become the next great Masako? Kid, honestly, I would like to be, I would love to be a father, either to a son, daughter, or whoever they wish to identify as, quite frankly. Just as long as it's a kid, look after them, spoil them, show them loads of geeky stuff, make sure they're smart, something that's eccentric. Mundane Joel, any plans to come to the US? Yes, I'll be there in July for Independence Day at Anime Expo in LA. Superfighter, you're not really keen on JoJo? that's fair enough. I try and convince people that, you know, it's something that, yeah, it's something worth your time. But, you know, if it's not people's cup of tea, then that's fair enough. Oh, yeah, if there's one thing. If your partner says that they're not worried about you being a dad or you being a mum, you pretty much nailed it. Like, you are good. You are fine. If your partner has no worries about you being a parent, then you got it. You've done good. Oh, yeah, no, Badlands. I have two nephews. One of them's 7. When they're 8, it's time for them to showcase the Dragon Room. I mean, they've been in here before, but they don't get the context. Dragon Ball, I will talk to their mum, so it'll be my sister-in-law eventually, and see if it's time to let out Dragon Ball and actually show them what I actually do. So, it's close. I've got 2 nephews, and it'll be like, it's almost time. It's almost time for them. But for any kids of mine, I'm pretty sure I'll introduce Dragon Ball to them a lot sooner than 8. You know, that'll be cool. No, definitely look forward to that. Hey, hi Gore, or Higor, greetings from Brazil. Oh, cool. Good to see you on the chat. Oh, July, it wouldn't be just here's my dragon room. Enter the dragon room. I'm actually really proud because I've actually put up shelving. So it's always one of those, it's one of those turning points when you have your own place. And it's not rent control or anything like that, you can put shelves up. And that's always a lot of fun, definitely. Alright, John, take it easy. No, don't worry about it. I'll see you around. Yeah, and JG, I didn't have a dragon room until Philly and I moved in. Oh, it's purple. Oh, it can be many things. Oh, it can definitely be many things. It can be many different colors. Yeah, I got those like Philips Hue bulbs. I'm very much into color. So I can make it orange if I want. Or let's say, you know, I'm feeling a bit green. Feeling a bit green today. Or, you know, Danger Chan from the PUBG things. If, you know, feeling a bit red. I'm going Super Saiyan God right here. Or Arctic Aura if it's like really blue. Super Saiyan blue right here. But yeah, now let's go back to a setting I have sunset musing. Sunset musing's always really good. Ah, Marika! Biggest fan from Finland. My nephews are half Finnish, actually. That's a lot of fun. You know. Actually, I loved Finland. I love the Nordic countries. Nordic countries are the best. So, I've been to Norway, I've been to Finland, I've been to Denmark. I really should go to Sweden. Okay, thanks for the pronunciation, Igor. Cheers. Yeah. Denmark, most of all, I feel like that's my spiritual home. Or Norway, those two, definitely. But Finland is absolutely beautiful. Kuopio, spending a lot of time in Kuopio, that was always really good. Donald, thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. And the BitBoy, you're saying stuff? Good. Saying stuff's always really good. Badlands, does my fiance have a YouTube channel? No, she does not. She is strictly offline. But who knows? You know, if we do have a kid, she might want to branch out and doing some stuff with nature or with art. Not sure. It's up to her. You know, if she wants to do it. My opinions on the Netherlands. I don't know, my opinion's pretty flat. I'm not sure whether you'd actually get a rise out of that. Let that sink one in. I'll let that one sink in for a bit. One Piece say, name them any nerdy, geeky anime names. Annabelle May, Annie May. Okay. That is so lame. I love it. I love puns. I love corny jokes. I'm like, that's my jam. I will say you something. When I was 15, I was so convinced I would name my daughter Videl. I was like, what was I thinking? Like, I instantly go back and think, oh, jeez. Can't believe I let myself do that. And I told my English teacher. I was like, I even told my English teacher I was going to do that. So I was like, what was I on? I probably admit I was such a weeboo when I was younger. Oh, yeah, I know there are dumber names. Videl's not essentially a dumb name. It's just not, you know, if you tell them it's an anagram for the word devil, people who aren't Dragon Ball fans aren't going to get it. They're going to think you're weird. Will your nephews be a ring bearer at your wedding? No fear. No fear. We're not trusting the rings with them. We're going to give them Haribo rings. Jared, have I visited the Caribbean or the Caribbean? No, actually, we haven't. Yeah, you know, kind of beachy countries are not really our jam. We prefer city breaks. But having said that, there's a lot of cool nature in the Barbados and the Caribbean. So we might end up there eventually. Badlands. Unfortunately, my fiance, she would rather be off camera. So if you go on some of the vlogs on this channel, you actually will be able to hear her voice. And sometimes she does, like, showcase stuff. Usman, what if Yajirobe trained, please? Like, what if, you know, Yajirobe put in effort? And wow, Axel Stan Lee, thank you so much, dude. That's really, really cool. Cheers. By any chance, are you coming up with any new what-ifs, or are you going to just finish all the current what-ifs? To that part, I will say, ideally, I really should finish more of the ones I've already done, or at least put them to bed for a while. And I do have more what-ifs planned. There is one, there is a new one coming out next week. And it is, what if the Supreme Kai did his job? I'm trying to find a more sensationalist title. So, like, what if the Supreme Kai wasn't lame? I want to say didn't suck, but I'm not sure whether the algorithm would actually really appreciate that. I'm not sure whether they would. And also, can I get a shout out? I'm also trying to do what ifs myself. Axel Stanley? Well, absolutely. The one thing I will say to you guys is that just because I do what ifs doesn't mean that you can't. You can. You are more than free to do what ifs yourself. I'm just one person that happens to do what ifs. Everybody has a different interpretation. That's the way I see it. So if you see me doing a what if, I don't want you to think, oh, great, I can't do that anymore. Of course you can. I want you to. I actively encourage you to do your own version of a what if I've done. So you have my permission to do your own interpretation. Just try and don't copy me, like, you know, verbatim, or just put your own spin on it. That's all I'll say. Because what ifs are intrinsically Dragon Ball. That's what they are. So it's definitely something you should really look into doing. Because it's a lot of fun. It's really good to help build up storytelling. Kyle Kicker, I did say ring bearers. No, they won't be. No, Super Fighter, it doesn't have to be a what if on just purely Dragon Ball. It can be about anything, really. Advice for anybody who wants to become YouTubers. Well, I was actually doing that with my friend Dave. He does, like, a music channel about, like, covers, piano covers, and I've helped him. It's actually been my first job of being, like, a full-blown YouTube consultant for somebody, and it's, like, one of Philly's friends' husbands. You know, he's a cool dude. Dave's a cool dude. Very talented with piano. He's got a channel called Mellow Dave's, and I've been helping him out with that. But all I'll say is that realistically, you just need to kind of just have an idea that you want to do, have conviction that you want to do it, like, passion, because people can see that. And just give it a go. Give it a try. Pretty much. And for Axel Stanley, good luck to you. And, you know, go and look him up. Lord, thanks for clicking on this video. Be sure to subscribe and don't forget to press the bell notification icon to hear the latest informations and discussions. Alright, Spectre, take care. Has that become a meme now as well? For me going, thanks for clicking on this video. Is that another meme? Do I have to make that into a shirt now? I wouldn't be surprised if I have to. Michael Rett, what if Raditz turned good movie edition? Oh boy, if I did that, I'd be really milking it. That'd be really milking it. But then again, there isn't much to do with Super. But having said that, you never know what's going to happen post May the 9th. You never know. That's super fun to put it on my shirt. Yes. So many different memes. I like it. It means you guys have got in-jokes. There are in-jokes to be had. Badlands. Frieza turned good at birth. I don't know. I really don't want to do... Oh, Axel, thank you very much. Alex, sorry. I don't know. I don't think I could do a Frieza turn good. I've done too many turn goods now. I'm trying to knock those on the head for a while. Just to kind of make sure that, yeah, I don't over-egg the pudding, as it were. Yeah, I voice Goku.
Well, of course I voice Goku, so of course pudding is always going to be somehow finagled in there.
What if other animes or TV shows? Ooh. I don't know. I don't think I could do that. Like, it just doesn't seem like I need to really have a lot of information about it to really justify it. What if Bra was sent back in time? Thank you very much, EC Cones. I don't know. Depends on what age. Depends how old she is. Malak, am I ever going to do thing that Lord Zidane's story with R&R eventually, season 2? Because I think for season 1, I want to make it quite slice of lifey. And then for season 2, we can do something a bit more fun. Like a side story. Charles Holmes, am I going to do anything for Goku Day? Probably if there's some news coming out. There may be a special margin news. Actually, when's the May 9th? Oh, it's Sunday. Ah, Sunday. Hey, guys. What would be the odds that they release an episode of Super on that day? Like, it's just, surprise, here's Super. I really wouldn't be surprised if they did that. They just suddenly announced it. Jay Andrews, thank you so much, dude. And Sin Overlord. Jay says, hi, Moscow, I'm your number one fan. I love and live your what ifs, like what if Gine and Goku was a girl. Anyway, I'm your biggest fan. Tell Philly I said hi. Don't worry, Jay. She might be watching, so if she is, I'm sure she'll say hi. Sin Overlord, do you mind if I send you a drawing on Twitter so you can add it to your drawing videos? I don't really do the drawing videos at the moment, I'm afraid. But, you know, if you want to, send it. I'll be more than glad to share it. But yeah, no, absolutely. Again, thank you so much. Yeah, Charles, I hope that I get R&R out for Goku Day as well, to be honest. I mean, it's just, at the moment, you know, it's just like, I don't know. There's a lot of variables to be had, and my artists are very talented, but they're also very busy. And it has been slightly mismanaged in a way. You know, a lot of things, my morale's not been very good at the moment. So part of it is my B, but I am working on that to make sure that it changes, and that means we're starting to work on the next episode as we're ending episode 4. R&R, character art has been done. We're working on background art right now. The audio for it is complete. So it's the basic done is already done. The basic thing's already complete. Some random guy that likes memes? Totally not. Mark was one of the artists for R&R for a while for the first 2 episodes. So it's definitely something that I'd love to do a video with him. I'd love to. Definitely. I think he might be going to SayerCon. Totally not, Mark. So we might do a collaboration video while we're over there. Yeah, let's just take a look back. Yeah, but if something doesn't happen on Sunday, I suppose really there'll be at least the Super Dragon Ball Heroes episode 11 thing I could do. I could do a review on that. There's something like that at least, if it ends up being a completely defunct duck, pretty much. What if Zangia turned good? Well, that'd be interesting. That'd be pretty interesting just to see how that happened. Whether that actually do anything? Mike Smith, thank you very much. Thank you. I hope that we do too. That is the backbone of most marriages, or ideally. Mark, you've been a fan for over a year, it seems. You've been wanting to hear my ideas on Super Saiyan 4 being incorporated into the future of Super. I think what we got with Broly in the Broly movie might be what we get in that regard, I think. I think that's probably what we'll look into. You know, kind of like a combination using some kind of elements of the power. That's what I think. Have I ever met any voice actors from the Dragon Ball series? Yes, I've met quite a few. I went to Kamehacon last year, and that was a lot of fun. That was definitely a lot of fun. I really enjoyed that. Getting the hangout with Sabat was a lot of fun, definitely. I actually helped him. One time he was really hungry. He was at a Cambridge convention, and Philly had studied in Cambridge, and we were there as well. So, take care, Michael. And he didn't know that pubs closed at 9. So we found a pub that closed at 11. So we introduced him to pizza burgers. That was fun. I think Jessica Calvello is my favorite, one of my favorite people to hang out with, voice actors. She's always got a lot of fun. Then, of course, there's Damon Mills, who's the stand-in for Frieza. And I met Chris Ayres as well. Chris Ayres and his partner, Crystal, they are two lovely beings. They are two very lovely people. And I really hope that Chris gets better. Absolutely. I think Morgan LeRae. I met her, I think, a thing. Have I met Sean Schemmel? No. I have not. I did get come close, though. It was at Last Kamehacon. And I was walking somewhere. He was coming out of a panel. And we kind of like, we did one of those anime situations. You know how you two people kind of just go? It's like, it goes like, doo, 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 doo. Yeah, it just time slows down. And it's like, I don't know whether he saw me or not. I saw him. I panicked. Oh boy, I panicked. I was like, I'm not ready for this. So I just bent down like I was like, I dropped some figurative change. Don't mind me. Oh, okay. Thunderstrike. Oh, okay. Sorry, I was looking at June. No, you're right. Thursday is the 9th. My B. All right, Shot Pile. Take care. Good to see you around. Stealthinator? What if Turles and Raditz and Nappa turn good? So what, like, three Saiyans turn good at the same time? Again, I'm trying to curb the turn good things for a while, knock those on the head. Just not oversaturate it in a way, if you know what I mean. And Jason Grimm, I have noticed you. And Super Fighter? Honestly, I'm not bothered about what Sean thinks, to be honest. I'm not bothered. It's his opinion. I'm like, that's fair enough. So I'm like, not much I can do. I don't voice Goku in an official capacity, and I don't think I ever will. In fact, I know I won't. I absolutely know won't. Hey, Mark. Oh, hi, Mark. We were just talking about you. You want to collab sometime? You want to do a... Hey, bruh. You want a collab? That's how YouTubers talk, right? Oh, cool, Shark. Cool. But I think an absolute one serious thing that I can say on the record is that regarding Mr. Schemmel, I have no beef with him. I'm like, he is Goku. He is Goku, pretty much. Mr. Calamus is Goku. Mr. Morrow is Goku. And, of course, Mr. Corlett anyone who's voiced Goku in an official capacity, even old Mr. Bloom in the final map game, they are Goku. I am not. So, it's all good. There's no beef. There's absolutely no beef. There may be bacon, but you know what they say about Goku and bacon? They go like that. And that's pretty much it, really. So I'm not salty at all. I'm about as salty as reduced salt bacon. And Super Fighter, that is indeed kind of you to say. But the one big thing about being in a relationship with Philly, she helps keep your feet on the ground. She keeps your feet on the ground. The slightest hint of me being ever arrogant, she's on me. And I'm grateful for that. Absolutely grateful. Because you need that. You need to have a good sense of perspective about stuff. Like, you need to understand what's, you know, to, you know, keep yourself real. And I appreciate that. It's just nice. Like, for example, like going to the garden center just down the road, or going out to do the shopping. Those kind of just normal things. I like that. It's nice. In fact, and Sharp Path, thank you very much. I got all my work done today. I was only going to edit one video for next week today. Philly encouraged me to do all three. So they're all done, pretty much. That's, you know, she pushed me to be better. And that was good. And I needed that. So, you know, it was just something really, really good. You got to admit, your videos might have had a lot of pull in the Dragon Ball development studios. Say you promote any idea, the likeness of the higher-ups hearing you is quite high. I will say, it was pretty interesting. The fact that in Dragon Ball Legends, there was a Yamcha Titans banner on that game. And I'm like, oh, what are we doing? What did we promote at Christmas? Yamcha with the Titans. Jared, take care, dude. Take it easy. And also, Havrock and I, for the last year, ever since we did our thing about how Barbity was underused and Dragon Ball needed more magic and more necromancy, we get Moro. How interesting. It's my personal belief. And I would put on a tin hat right now, but I don't have any tin. So I'll just put a cat hat on. So like that. This is my cat hat of conspiracy. So from now on, this is the cat hat of conspiracy. It's my belief that Toei does watch my videos. Because a lot of things about ideas for stories, I think they're watching. And my personal belief is that with the whole geekdom, super rumor coming back thing, and the fact that Toei took it seriously, they watch his videos. Who's to say they don't watch everyone else's in the Dragon Ball community sphere? Oh yeah, and this actually has a very, very old Master Ko X badge. Like, this is like circa 2013 or something like that. But yeah, this is me with the hashtag cat hat of conspiracy. So yeah, that's a thing now. Actually, I'm trying to see where it came from. It was made in China by a Fur Yu Corporation. But yeah. Cat Haft of Conspiracy says, Toei's watching me. Oh! When I used to wear a fedora, well, it wasn't a fedora, it was a trilby. And I did retire it. I did retire it. Years ago. And, you know, the one thing that made me realize that I had to stop wearing it was, what's the name of the Texas convention? Akon, that's it. Akon in Dallas, Texas, 5 years ago. And, Kaiser and I were in a lift. And, I was wearing the hat. And some guy behind me just went like, hey, nice hat. And Kaiser got to my defense, bless him. He was like, is that supposed to be sarcastic? And he was like, yeah. I was like, oh man, really? Oh, D-Mels. Thank you very much. So what if DBS comes back as DB Ultra, therefore proving Toei, so that way everyone is wrong and right, and the whole DB community blows up in panic? That is a bit of an unexpected thing. But I think without the whole thing, Toei wants to release this series on its own terms, as far as I see. They want, of course they're going to deny it, and everyone that works for them is going to deny it, because that's the party line. So of course they are. They want to release the Super series, if there is a new one, or whatever they call it, on their own terms, with their own event. You know, that's pretty much how they want to do it. They want to do it on their, you know, how they want to do it, not by having to react to a leak. That's pretty much what it is, really. Nizbatron, congratulations to you both, Masako. I'm getting married myself in 24 days. Congratulations. So my wife-to-be and I both send our love. All the best, mate. Well, all the best to you too. I hope you have a fantastic time. And 24th, a May wedding. Yeah, absolutely great. I'm absolutely proud of you guys. And just have a good one. Absolutely. It's going to be a fantastic day. Super Suit. Hi, Masako, my daughter and I love your videos. Oh, cheers. Oh, thank you so much. I actually have a funny, it's not a funny story, but it's more like, it's a really sweet story. Like, Philly and I, we were at MCM in October, and this father brings his 12-year-old daughter to the booth and says that it's essentially, they have some daddy-daughter time watching DBZA and my content. And it's just one of those times that it just makes me go, like, oh, man. Yeah, that's what makes it worth it, you know, when, yeah, you know, a father and their child can actually do some bonding and over just one thing. That was really touching. I really liked that. That was just a really nice time. Just really good to actually hear that. And then it goes from sweet to funny when a baby was watching my videos and the parents changed the channel and the baby cried until they put it back. But I don't think it had something to do with my content. It was to do with the fact this forehead. Because all babies out there, they never cry when they see me. They have this odd expression of like, are you? I'm like, I'll take that. I'd rather have a baby look at me oddly than a baby crying in my presence. I will take that. Dave Weatherall, thank you very much. Sin of the Lord. But Masako! Actually, no, I can actually do it better.
But Masako!
There we go, soundboard. How come you haven't done a marketing video compilation? Because the chap who did it at Classy Reviews, that video, I don't want to overload him. That's too much work for him to do, bless him. Andre Partridge, congratulations on your wedding from your biggest fan in Omaha, Nebraska. Well, thank you very much, Andre. Thank you. Thank you. Goku's voice.
I am a turtle. I know someone who's a turtle. After I ate Icarus, I had a hankering for the turtle. Turtle soup.
Yeah, it's just, yeah, the baby's thinking, it's the glasses, man! Pretty much. Zion, you two want your own kids? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we down for kids. I have to have them eventually. I'm not getting any younger. No, definitely getting any younger. Let's see. Igor, will there be muffins at the reception? There'll be cupcakes at the very least. The gluten-free cupcakes. Because we have the cake. We got a three-tier cake. One's like, you know, we got a fruitcake one. We got a Victoria sponge. Red velvet at the bottom. So we got that. And we'll have some little gluten-free cupcakes knocking around for anybody who, you know, who has a gluten allergy. So there you go. Dave Witherall. Your hat looked cool, by the way, Lawrence. Best of wishes to you and Philly on the wedding. I hope you guys make it to the North Lincolnshire one day. Well, you know, you never know. You never know where it might be. Tell you what. I'll go and get the old Trilby. I'll go and get the old Trilby out. One sec.
Wait one caller. I've just got to be 1 second because it's really dark in there. I need my light. Oh, here we go. Got it. Yay, I got it. It's pretty old. It's pretty old. But yeah, so I've not worn this in like 5 years. You know, it's really old and it's covered in pins. And I don't know whether I can still do it, but it's just like that. I don't know why. It started off like this. Various different badges on it. And I'm like, bless it. I would not wear this again. I would not wear this out in public. Well, I may be wearing it ironically. But yeah, various things back in the days when I had a somewhat appreciation for, you know, friendship is magic. You know, that kind of stuff back in those days. As well, of course, Nando's, a Delta thing. I got on a flight with Tarka one time. The Hand of the King, Game of Thrones, of course. Yeah, it's not that pointy. A couple of rainbow badges. Baltimore Orioles, there. You see, it wasn't all just pony stuff. There's some Azumanga Daioh things in here as well. But yeah. So. Slot lottery tap. And that's it. Yeah, you can go sit on the cat hat conspiracy. Oh, Gideon. I want you to have a great honeymoon. I love your videos so much. Oh, cheers, dude. Very much appreciated. Let's see. When am I going to... Marika says, promise us that when you have kids, you won't stop doing what you do completely. We love you and your content so much. Well, Philly has, Philly and I will make plans to make sure that we can still do the content, at the very least. So, you know, I think that's pretty much, don't worry, we'll still have that plenty of time to go, absolutely. But yeah. The cat hat has its own hat, too. Yeah, pretty much. It's kind of like... It's its own thing now. Stealthinator, do I have any pets? Yes, I do. I have a Smokey. I have a Smokes. So, yeah, I definitely have that. But yeah, I think it's time... We'll probably call time on now the stream because, you know, my throat's starting to go. And, yeah. That's pretty much what I do, really. I thought I wanted to play a game or anything like that. And hey, Mark says he wants to collab. Woo! Yeah! Cool. We'll have to think of something. But, yeah. Okay. Anyway, guys. If you came over from the main channel, thank you so much for coming over. Be sure to subscribe. I think I'll pretty much do most of my streams here now because the algorithm doesn't mind me doing streams like this on this channel. But on the other channel, no. Doesn't work. This one works way better. And Sin Overlord, Goku, I challenge you to drink a gallon of grape juice or eat a box of cookies. And remember, it's a challenge. You never back down from a challenge.
That is very true. Alright, I'll drink the gallon.
No, seriously, I'll try and drink a gallon. Fortunately, a US gallon is smaller than a UK gallon, so that's not too much of a... It's less of a challenge. But yeah. Anyway. Stealthinator, I have noticed you. And, yeah. So, we'll be going back to some nice little streams on this second channel. Back in the old days, almost were. Like, back in 2015. That seems really nice. Something we can actually do on this channel. But yeah. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you have a good rest of your day. And I really appreciate the time just to chill. And I'll come up with some new layout here to reflect that. Something more akin to the LS thing. So, just take care, guys. And all I can say, yeah, I love you guys. And one is glad to be of service.